the expenditure of funds that need to be made in order to get this redeployment issue into some kind of sanity. And believe me, we acted as is our responsibility because of our intense frustration about the lack of progress on this issue. And now 2.5 months go by and they haven't even let a contract to get an independent assessment, by the way, and we wanted it to be completed by the 1st of April, the end of March, which obviously cannot happen. I'm not going to let you continue to slow walk us on this issue. Just put things in perspective on the F-35 again. We started the program in 2001. The cost estimates for a couple of thousand aircraft, 2,456 aircraft, were going to be $238 billion. We've now had additional costs of $150 billion, $150 additional billion in costs. Block 4, as I understand it, please correct me if I'm wrong, General Amos, Block 4, 32 aircraft, which are approximately 50% complete, are now $500 million over originally estimated costs. Are those figures wrong?
Senator, I can't say whether the figures are wrong or not.
You know what the initial cost was supposed to be, General?
Oh, I do. I was deputy head of aviation.
Then,
it was significant.
Is that fact wrong?
That fact is pretty close, sir.
And there's been $150 billion additional cost overrun. Is that fact true?
Sure, I can't comment on that. I don't even know
what the cost overrun has been.
Well, this is not a single point in time. I've noticed the program go. I went through the technical baseline review last year, $4.5 billion.
Let me interrupt you again. Do you argue the fact that there's been $150 billion additional cost of the aircraft since the original estimate of $238 billion?
Sir, I can't comment on that. I can't tell you whether it's $150 billion. I know it's significant.
So, for the record, you don't know how much the cost overrun has been for the F-35?
Not precisely.
Roughly. Do you know roughly what the cost overrun has been?
Sure, I'm assuming since, no, I don't.
Remarkable. So we continue to have $500 million cost overruns on additional 32 aircraft that are 50% complete. Does then that mean, Mr. Secretary, that we will have $1 billion cost overrun since the aircraft are 50% complete on Block 4 aircraft?
Senator, I don't know if you could make that that extrapolation or not.
Well, all I can say is that I have been watching this aircraft since 2001, and I've watched the cost overruns now, and I don't believe that it's inaccurate to state there's been roughly $150 billion additional costs, and we are now still in the early stages of what was planned to be 2,456 aircraft planned. What is your assessment, Mr. Secretary, of the situation as regards the F-35 now?
The situation for the Navy and Marine Corps as regards the F-35 is because of some of the issues that you've identified with concurrency and with the readiness of the aircraft. We have reduced the number of planes that we are going to buy over the FYDP, but we have remained constant in the number of total aircraft that we will buy in the program. 680 aircraft total for the Department of the Navy. That's 420 for the Marine Corps, including 360 Bs and 80 Cs for the Marines, the remainder C variant for the Navy. It's a capability that we need. It's a capability that the Marine Corps does not have a backup plan for. You correctly pointed out that we have bought the Harriers from the British when they retired their carrier. We did that to extend the life of the Harrier to make sure that we had the vertical takeoff and landing capabilities in place until the arrival in sufficient numbers of the F-35B.
Yeah.
Thank you.
So the
F-35
is going to Israel.
Cost overruns are $1 billion, and I'm not sure how much it is complete. Will the Navy be asking for legislative relief from the cost cap of $600 million?
Senator, not this year, but I'm certain we will be asking next year.